Important game coming up on Christmas Day right here on NFL Network. The Steelers trying to ensure that first round by Reggie Wayne and Sean O'Hara. They are playing the Texans. Of course, they're going to be playing without Antonio Brown. How much of an issue is that going to be against a team that really has struggled for most of the year?
Well, obviously, whenever you lose the best receiver in the league, it's alarming. But this Pittsburgh Steelers team, offensively, they're still talented. You still have Lev Bell. You got Juju Smith-Schuster, Martavius Bryant. I mean, you're going to see more Jesse James. I mean, they have pieces in place to make plays for them. Now, all hands are going to be on deck. What this does is this opens up your offense just a little bit more. Everybody has to step their level up and play that much to add that void of AB. But I think they can get it done. This team really should have beat the number one seeded team, New England Patriots. So they have everything, still have Big Ben. They can get it done.
That controversial call with Jesse James there right on the goal line, the initial touchdown ruled no catch. What do you think?
You got to survive the ground.
You do. Well, that's always been the rule. Hasn't changed.
Ground's got to give.
I don't know why everybody's trying to all of a sudden change the rule. It's been like that for a while. So I think the wide receiver position is the one area where the Steelers have so much depth that they could actually overcome a loss of AB. When you're looking at the Steelers offense, to me, it's can they protect Ben? Now, this was supposed to be the Watt Bowl, right? It's supposed to be J.J. Watt and T.J. Watt, the brothers getting to play against each other. But Jadeveon Clowney is the game wrecker. Now, the key for the Steelers is they're getting their right tackle back, Marcus Gilbert, from suspension. So that will help out. But when you look at the Texans, really, offensively, I mean, let's be honest. Who do they have? If you're the Steelers, you got to take one guy away. You got to take DeAndre Hopkins away. If you take him away, now you're forcing – T.J. Yates to try to beat you with somebody else. I mean, this guy, it's really remarkable when you think about how productive he's been. And you look at how many quarterbacks have been throwing passes. I mean, it's like doing a TV show with Dan Helly. you got all these guys that you just hope that the ball is going to get there. You don't know if it's going to skip rocks or if it's going to end up in the ocean. But I think DeAndre, when you look at the Steelers' defense, I mean, obviously they're going to try to take him out of the game and force them to do some other things. But I think also for the Steelers, this is good for them going forward. Yeah. It gives them a good test because in the playoffs, guess what? You might end up facing a team that has a receiver kind of like that. You get to the Super Bowl, maybe you end up playing Julio Jones. So now you get a chance to let your corners go against a big receiver.
I want to see what Martavis Bryant can do. He was whining early in the year about not getting the ball enough, suspended for a game, basically a healthy scratch.
Wanted a trade.
Right, now it's your turn, Martavis, to step up and accomplish something.
And this is what Coach Mike Tomlin was talking about. When he wanted to trade and demanding to leave and all that stuff, Coach Tomlin said, he's not going anywhere. We're going to need him at the end of this season, and this is his time right now to step up and make big plays.
It's interesting for Martavis because he's usually outside, but Juju could end up getting a lot of those slot throws.
That's a good point. I set you both up very nicely in this segment.
Nicely done. You redeemed yourself.
Not T.J. Yates. T.J. Yates. I can't say the name.